You've been lied to by the North Star. Drop everything and let me give you a really fun fact about the North Star to share with your friends and family, in the hopes of sounding a little smarter and up to date in the science field. Everything we know about this star has just been put under a huge question mark. Polaris, also known as the North Star, has been guiding travelers for centuries in determining the direction of north on Earth. This star is located in the constellation Ursa Minor, commonly known as the Little Dipper. Thanks to its fixed position relative to the Earth's rotation axis, Polaris remains almost directly above the North Pole throughout the night. This makes it a reliable reference point for navigators, astronomers, and even everyday stargazers who want to locate the north direction since the beginning of civilization. At the center of the Little Dipper, Polaris is part of a triple star system. It consists of a primary star and two companions, which are much fainter and orbit around the main star. The interesting aspect of Polaris that we will be focusing on is its pulsating nature. It periodically varies in brightness, which can be clearly observed and determined by astronomers. This characteristic is usually studied to gain insights into the distance of stars and gain more information on the acceleration rate of the universe. These specifically rhythmic pulsating stars are called Cepheid variable stars. Keep that in mind while watching the video. What is happening? Very recent studies have shown that the pulsations of the star haven't been showing exactly what we expected them to. Its pulsations have been undergoing weird changes in the past 200 years, and we only really notice today. It seems like this is causing the science community to no longer be able to agree neither on the size nor on the distance of Polaris from us. Why? Well, because what we thought was a classical, stable Cepheid variable is actually changing its periods many times throughout the years. It was known that Polaris had a strictly programmed pulsating period of every 4 days, meaning that every 4 days, Polaris would go on a full cycle of being extremely bright and then extremely dark, etc. Or at least, that's what we thought. Let's see this in more details. But before that, it's important to state the information regarding what types of stars are orbiting Polaris. Types of stars around it. The Polaris I keep mentioning is the main star, more professionally called Polaris AA. It is a yellow supergiant, also called an F-type star. Astronomers seem to like putting simple letters on stars. Anyway, Polaris is 5.5 times the mass of our dear Sun, and it is our main focus because it is also the famous Cepheid variable in the triplet. Moving on to one of the orbiting stars, the closer one is called Polaris AB, and it is kind of similar in mass with our Sun. Polaris AB revolves around Polaris AA in a pretty slow orbit with a period of approximately 29 years. The last little orbiting star is one that is so much further away from these two that one could wonder how it even ended up in this triple system. Anyway, can you imagine that it is 2,400 astronomical units far away from the main star and orbits it with a period of 40,000 years? We expect that the distance of Polaris from the Earth is around 448 light years, just for reference. Direct observations. Here's the interesting part about Cepheid variables. Their total brightness is directly linked to their pulsation. It's like their own little light show. So if we look at these special stars that are really far away, we can actually figure out exactly how far they are. How, you ask? Well, we can determine their total luminosity. Recently, some smart folks decided to use the James Webb Space Telescope to take a closer look at about 300 of these stars. Their goal was to confirm the distances to different galaxies and see if they could solve the famous cosmic mystery known as the Hubble tension. This mystery has to do with how the universe is expanding, how fast it's going, and it's been really bugging scientists for a while now, trust me. Now, the James Webb Telescope is like the Sherlock Holmes of space exploration. It's got all these fancy instruments to help us investigate the mysteries of the universe. So, the scientists collected data from these Cepheid stars and analyzed it with the help of the telescope. And guess what they found? The Hubble tension is still hanging around like a pesky mosquito. It turns out the universe isn't expanding at the same rate everywhere you look. It's like a speed limit sign got all mixed up and confused. But let's break it down a little bit more. Imagine you're at a race, and all the runners are supposed to be going at the same speed. But when you actually watch them, some runners are going faster and some are going slower. It's chaos, right? Well, that's pretty much what's happening with the expansion of the universe. The galaxies are like those runners, all going at different speeds. So what does this mean? It means that the Hubble tension is a real deal. It's not just some fluke or mistake. Our universe is a bit wonky and we still don't know why. It's like trying to solve a Rubik's Cube that keeps changing colors every time you turn it. Even though the Hubble tension is a bit frustrating, it's also exciting. It means there's still so much we have to learn about the universe we live in. Something is weird. Recently, the observations from Polaris have added a new twist to the story. Astronomers have been keeping tabs on it and have noticed some interesting things. Back in 1911, they figured out that Polaris is a pulsating star. But what's really fascinating is that over the course of the 20th century, the period of its pulsations has been slowly increasing. It's like the star is taking longer and longer to complete one full pulsation. However, the total amplitude or the size of the brightness change has been getting smaller. It's like the star is becoming less flamboyant with its pulsations. But here's where it gets even weirder. Between 1963 and 1965, something unexpected happened. The pulsations actually reversed for those years, and nobody knows why. It's like Polaris decided to flip the script and confuse everyone. This phenomenon has been ongoing for more than a century, with the pulsations gradually intensifying, although the increase is not significant. At present, the only hypothesis we have is that Polaris comprises three stars in a system. It is possible that one of the stars is influencing the primary star, causing it to pulsate at slightly varying intervals and with reduced intensity. Nonetheless, this is merely speculation, and we have yet to establish a concrete explanation. But hold on, because there's more. In the last few years, things have taken an even stranger turn. You thought you were done, didn't you? Nope. Around 2010, instead of the period continuing to increase, it started to decrease. It's like Polaris decided to change its mind and confuse us even more. And in the 1990s, the pulsations became so small that they almost disappeared completely. It was like the star was playing a disappearing act on us. All these changes were measured using something called radial velocity, which looks at the total velocity of the star by analyzing its red shift and blue shift. Scientists have collected nearly 4,000 measurements over the past 60 years, and based on these measurements, the amplitude of the changes seems to be coming down. It's like Polaris is slowly calming down and becoming more stable. So what does all of this mean? Well, right now we don't have all the answers. But like I gave you a little hint about it earlier, we do have some possible explanations to this mess. Possible causes we know of. As we get into the intricacies, it becomes a little apparent that the cause lies within the orbital dynamics at play. Let's take a closer look at the enigmatic situation. To quickly recap, our attention is drawn to the main star, which happens to be accompanied by a neighboring star that orbits it every 29 years. This celestial companion could be holding a key role in this. It influences over the upper layers of the primary star, causing subtle shifts in their positions. The eccentric nature of their orbit amplifies these effects, particularly when the stars draw closer to each other. This celestial rendezvous occurs every 29 years, possibly triggering significant changes in the orbital dynamic of the two stars. Curiously, such a scenario also poses a challenge for astronomers seeking to chart a more precise and accurate orbit of the entire star system. The intricacies of these celestial motions make it incredibly challenging to map their paths with great precision. Consequences.